Ambush!
Their numbers are overwhelming. Surrender may be our only option.
No! Don't give them an inch!
Your move, Captain.
I'm aware of that, Mr. Spock.
Damn it!
Your choice was valid, Captain, but highly predictable.
Predictable? Since when have I ever been predictable?
That is precisely why the move was predictable, Captain.
Captain, we have received an emergency signal from a nearby space station. Please report to the bridge at once.
Shall we finish the game later, or do you concede defeat?
You should know me better than that by now, Spock. I never concede.
Try reversing the phase oscillation?
That's the first thing I tried.
I'm stumped.
What's going on down there?
The radiation from those binary stars is making communications difficult. But the station appears to be in some sort of distress.
Check off readings.
They're operating on emergency power and are struggling to maintain altitude.
Cause?
Unknown, sir.
Captain, they have issued a request for immediate evacuation.
Then let's help them out. Mr. Scott, prepare transporters.
I wouldn't recommend it, sir. Those stars are giving off too much interference. Unless we achieve manual lock, we might fry those little guys.
Then we'll get them out the old-fashioned way. Prepare my shuttle, meet me in the bay.
Aye, aye, sir.
Captain, in spite of your seemingly endless desire to stretch your legs, I must remind you that you are still a Starfleet captain. This is clearly a job that Mr. Scott and a few ensigns could handle.
But then I'd miss all the fun.
Sir, the more prudent choice would be to stay on the Enterprise and wait for a response to our hails.
Oh, you're right. Lieutenant Uhura, any response to our hails?
None, sir.
No? Looks like I'm going.
Captain, I must insist.
You insist? You know what, Mr. Spock? A change of scenery might do you some good.
Captain?
You come with me.
Your shuttle's ready, Captain. But do you think it's wise to go yourself? I'm sure me and some recruits could handle this.
Don't worry, Scotty. We'll be fine.
Always makes me nervous when he says that.
Suited up.
Enterprise shuttle, confirming approach at 5x6. Maintain minimal safe distance.
Affirmative, Enterprise. I'm picking up high levels of radiation from two binary stars.
A normal space station would have been fried by those two stars by now. What the hell are they doing out there?
Captain, the station appears to be outfitted with solar collectors, but they are unlike any I have ever encountered.
Mr. Sulu, do you have any clue what an experimental power station would be doing out here in the middle of nowhere?
Negative, Captain. Whatever they're doing, Starfleet doesn't have any record of it. Preparing for final approach.
Keep the engine running, Mr. Sulu. I don't think we plan on staying on that thing for too long.
Aye, Captain.
Officer, where is the captain of this station?
This way. You must hurry.
Damn it!
Is this the fun you were afraid you were going to miss, Captain?
Right. We need to get everyone out of here right away. Captain, we must find an alternate route.
Very perceptive, Mr. Spock.
Full. Anything we need to worry about right now?
The readings are off the charts, but I don't think so.
Just keep an eye on it, Mr. Chekhov.
Aye, aye, sir.
Formalities are unnecessary. Please proceed to the shuttle bay for immediate evacuation. Captain, I must mention that many of these crew members appear to be Vulcan.
Your point.
With fewer than 10,000 Vulcans remaining, I question the logic of placing them on any type of experimental power station.
I question putting anybody on this thing, Mr. Spock, Vulcan or not.
Agreed, sir. There must be a way to disable that laser. This station are most assuredly connected.
One catastrophe at a time, Mr. Spock.
Doesn't sound good. Captain, I would not advise stepping into that scanner.
No other way around, Spock.
Captain Kirk of the USS Enterprise, we have a shuttle ready for your evacuation.
While we appreciate your assistance, our captain and many of our top scientists are trapped in the transporter room on the other side of the station. We cannot simply abandon them.
Any suggestions, Mr. Spock?
If we were able to reach them, Mr. Scott may then be able to obtain a manual lock on our positions.
I'm afraid that may prove impossible. All interior passages are blocked.
Will the suits hold up out there?
With the solar shield failing, direct exposure would mean certain death.
Well, I hate certain death. Spock, let's try to avoid direct exposure.
Captain, I will offer whatever assistance I can over your communicator. But again, I fear that these efforts...
Yeah, we get it. Certain death. Any other words of advice?
Try to live long and prosper.
Should engage mag boots now, sir. The solar collector is failing. We must avoid direct exposure.
That suit is gonna melt off your back. Get into cover, Spock.
Captain, we should stay in cover until it regenerates.
Got it. Wait for it. Go, now!
Cover.
how much more exposure our suits can handle. Captain, we should stay in cover until it regenerates. Whose idea was this anyway?
I believe it was yours, sir.
Right.
The station's core. We seek whatever further assistance you can provide.
The only way forward is to shut down the core's rings. To do this, you will need to work together. One of you must scan the control console to stop the ring. This will allow the other person to engage the locking mechanism. Commander, I must warn you, a manual shutdown under these circumstances is highly risky.
Gotcha. You should split up.
I have located the control console. I believe I can scan it to stop the ring. Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism. Success, Captain. We must repeat the maneuver for the remaining rings.
Stop the ring. Spock, shoot the lock. Damn, it's moving again.
When the ring is stopped, that break is exposed.
Another one down. Just one more ring to go.
Release the mechanism.
That worked. Let's keep moving.
Take cover.
Oh,
should stay in cover until it regenerates.
Through the core, let's find that stranded crew. Get into cover. Great, no cover. I believe we may be able to open those vents. Perhaps our phasers will work. Worth a shot. It works! Keep shooting out those vents! Our attempt was successful. Quick, behind those barriers. Ah, watch out! Success, Captain. Careful, not all these vents are stable. Captain, stay in cover. Captain, we should stay in cover until it regenerates.
These things.
Captain, life support is now at 4% and failing. Transporter is still unable to obtain a reliable signal.
Let me worry about the transporter. Just get your people ready to beam out. What are you waiting for?
I was speaking to my captain.
It's all right, Commander. Do as he says.
Aye, Captain.
Ah, Captain. I don't believe we've met. I'm James Kirk, Captain of the USS Enterprise. You are?
I am in need of assistance, Captain.
Tamar?
Mr. Spock, it is a relief to see you here.
Tamar, in what way can we assist you?
Our station has experienced a complete loss of power. Our transporter functions are also unreliable. There does not appear to be a safe way to beam out.
There's always a way. Scotty, think you can get a lock on me?
I'll try, sir. What's going on down there, Captain?
That was a wake-up call, Mr. Scott. I need you to work a little faster.
On it, sir!
We should make our way to the transporter, Captain.
After you. So, how do you two know each other?
We were classmates back on Vulcan.
Just classmates?
I realize this may be difficult for you to understand, Captain, but on Vulcan, relationships between the sexes do not automatically imply an intimate past.
Another reason I'm glad I'm not a Vulcan.
Until my crew is safely out of danger. As a captain yourself, I'm sure you would do the same.
I like this one.
There are a few that you do not like, Captain. Prepare to energize.
Thank you. Are you all right, Captain?
I'm definitely better now, thanks.
Captain, we have a problem.
Another one?
What is it, Mr. Chekov?
I think you need to see for yourself.
Tamar, a simple solar flare should not have caused the loss of power to your station. Do you know the origin of your vessel's malfunction?
It did not malfunction.
Didn't appear that way to us.
That station was used to harness the energy from the binary stars. However, all of the station's primary controls were operated from a base located on a nearby planet.
What planet?
We are calling it New Vulcan.
So it is true.
Spock, as you know, after the destruction of Vulcan, we have been searching for a suitable planet to rebuild our race. New Vulcan seemed perfect. However, a project of this magnitude would have taken generations to complete. In order to speed up this process, we created a device called the Helios Machine.
Your station was to harness the energy from the binary stars to power the Helios Machine located on New Vulcan.
Precisely. 2 days ago, and for some unknown reason, the power to our station was shut off. Without power, our station could not withstand the gravitational pull of the stars.
What moron would shut down the machine if they knew this would happen?
That moron would be Serac.
Never heard of him.
Serac is Tamar's father, and a great mentor to myself and the Vulcan people.
Sorry?
Why would Serac shut down power to your station? He must have been aware that doing so would be catastrophic for you and your crew.
Unfortunately, the Helios machine may have caused an anomaly.
An anomaly? This just keeps getting better. We need to get to the bridge.
Chekov, tell me something.
It is highly unusual, sir, but I believe it's some kind of rip in the actual fabric of space.
Like a wormhole?
Something like that, sir. It appears to be a shortcut through space.
Where does it lead?
There is no way to know for sure, Commander.
I believe that rip is the reason my father ordered the Helios machine to be shut down.
Then we need to talk to him right away. Lieutenant Uhura, hail New Vulcan.
Aye, Captain.
It is no use, Captain. We lost communication with them when the Helios machine was shut down.
Captain, scans indicate the rip is contracting. At the current rate, it will be gone in approximately 12 hours.
Good. The fewer anomalies we have to deal with, the better.
Captain, no response to our hails.
Mr. Sulu, bring us in range of New Vulcan. We're going down there.
I may have to cancel our dinner plans.
So, this Tamar, she a friend of yours?
We went to school together on Vulcan. As a child, many of my peers resented my human side. Tamar did not.
I see. So, were you and Tamar?
I can assure you that our relationship was strictly platonic.
I didn't mean...
No offense taken. I would be more than willing to discuss my past with you any other time. I must request permission to join you, Captain.
Spock, are you sure that's within protocol? I mean, maybe we should just send Scotty and some recruits.
Captain, I hope the importance of New Vulcan is not lost on you. Our people cannot afford another tragedy. This planet is the best hope for our race to prosper.
Noted.
Then you should also note that having a Vulcan as a member of your away team would be essential to the success of this mission.
And I am the only one on this ship that has ever been on the surface of New Vulcan or has experience with the Helios machine.
All right. Great. Now there's two of you guys driving me nuts.
Transport ready, Captain.
My phaser, Mr. Scott?
I've put some wee modifications on it, just like you asked. I've been working on some other options, too. I've got phase cannons, photon disruptors, and wait till I show you these plasma rifles. Still working out a few things.
My phaser will do, Mr. Scott.
I guess you don't want to hear about the stasis grenades, then. Nasty little buggers. But if you want your phaser, here's your phaser.
Energize. any further out and I'd be back in Iowa, Mr. Scott.
Sorry, sir. Too much interference. I had to drop you outside.
Kind of quiet around here. Is that normal tomorrow?
Negative, Captain. For some reason, the highest security protocols have been enabled on this door.
Can we hack it?
Possibly, but you will have to work together to beat the encryption.
Captain, I need your assistance at this console. Captain, the system seemed to have been purposely shut down.
I can provide assistance.
Tamar, can you operate all the systems from here?
Yes. I helped build and design... Captain, if you are implying that I should stay behind...
Tamar, we may need your technical assistance should things get...
Unfriendly?
Unpredictable.
But my father...
When we find him, you'll be the first to know.
I will remain in constant contact.
Thank you.
Captain, shall we proceed?
After you.
I believe we have a problem.
Really? But you can't make that jump.
It is highly doubtful that either of us can cross unharmed. Dead, Captain.
Did you see that?
I did.
I wasn't right in the head.
I understand that our lives were at risk, but we must endeavor not to use lethal force.
Agreed. We both need to use stun from this point on. I think he's been poisoned.
Scans show numerous toxins in the adrenal glands and bloodstream. another disturbed individual.
We gotta take him out, but remember, stun only.
I would not have it any other way.
Who is that? Have you come to help us?
Are you sure you want to touch that guy?
A mind meld is our only option.
Anything?
I have never encountered this before. His mind has been corrupted. Also, I now know the code to that door.
Enterprise, we have injured. Prepare to transport.
Aye, sir. Everything all right?
Yeah, just some Vulcan problems.
So, the usual.
Captain, I am detecting several Vulcans behind this door, but their readings are erratic.
May I suggest setting our phasers to stun? After all, they are Vulcans.
more!
I hope you have...
Use stun!
Captain, I am detecting several Vulcans behind this door, but their readings are erratic.
May I suggest setting our phasers to stun? After all, they are Vulcans.
Let's find this Serac guy and get the hell out of here.
Officer.
Quickly. Come in.
Interesting. Another disturbed individual.
Thank you.
Ambush!
Their numbers are overwhelming. Surrender may be our only option.
No! Don't give them an inch!
Is your move, Captain.
I'm aware of that, Mr. Spock.
Damn it!
Your choice was valid, Captain, but highly predictable.
Predictable? Since when have I ever been predictable?
That is precisely why the move was predictable, Captain.
Captain, we have received an emergency signal from a nearby space station. Please report to the bridge at once.
Shall we finish the game later, or do you concede defeat?
You should know me better than that by now, Spock. I never concede.
Did you try reversing the phase oscillation?
That's the first thing I tried.
I'm stumped.
What's going on down there?
The radiation from those binary stars is making communications difficult, but the station appears to be in some sort of distress.
Check off readings.
They're operating on emergency power and are struggling to maintain altitude.
Cause?
Unknown, sir.
Captain, they have issued a request for immediate evacuation.
Then let's help them out. Mr. Scott, prepare transporters.
I wouldn't recommend it, sir. Those stars are giving off too much interference. Unless we achieve manual lock, we might fry those little guys.
Then we'll get them out the old-fashioned way. Prepare my shuttle, meet me in the bay.
Aye, aye, sir.
Captain, in spite of your seemingly endless desire to stretch your legs, I must remind you that you are still a Starfleet captain. This is clearly a job that Mr. Scott and a few ensigns could handle.
But then I'd miss all the fun.
Sir, the more prudent choice would be to stay on the Enterprise and wait for a response to our hails.
Oh, you're right. Lieutenant Uhura, any response to our hails?
None, sir.
No, looks like I'm going.
Lieutenant?
You'll be careful, won't you?
Caution is in my nature, Miura.
I know.
Captain, I must insist.
You insist? You know what, Mr. Spock? A change of scenery might do you some good.
Captain,
you come with me.
Your shuttle's ready, Captain. But do you think it's wise to go yourself? I'm sure me and some recruits can handle this.
Don't worry, Scotty. We'll be fine.
Always makes me nervous when he says that. Don't it?
Spock, get suited up.
Enterprise shuttle, confirming approach at 5x6. Maintain minimal safe distance.
Affirmative, Enterprise. I'm picking up high levels of radiation from two binary stars.
A normal space station would have been fried by those two stars by now. What the hell are they doing out there?
Captain, the station appears to be outfitted with solar collectors, but they are unlike any I have ever encountered.
Mr. Sulu, do you have any clue what an experimental power station would be doing out here in the middle of nowhere?
Negative, Captain. Whatever they're doing, Starfleet doesn't have any record of it. Preparing for final approach.
Keep the engine running, Mr. Sulu. I don't think we plan on staying on that thing for too long.
Aye, Captain.
Officer, where is the captain of this station?
This way. You must hurry.
Damn it!
Is this the fun you were afraid you were going to miss, Captain?
Right. We need to get everyone out of here right away.
Captain, we must find an alternate route.
Very perceptive, Mr. Spock. Full. Anything we need to worry about right now?
The readings are off the charts, sir, but I...
So. Just keep an eye on it, Mr. Chekhov.
Aye, aye, sir.
in there. Let's get him out of there.
I believe the door can be hacked from this side.
Please, you must be quick!
I am in your debt.
Formalities are unnecessary. Please proceed to the shuttle bay for immediate evacuation. Captain, I must mention that many of these crew members appear to be Vulcan.
Your point.
With fewer than 10,000 Vulcan. machines remaining, I question the logic of placing them on any type of experimental power station.
I question putting anybody on this thing, Mr. Spock, Vulcan or not.
Agreed, sir. Be a way to disable that laser. Station are most assuredly connected.
One catastrophe at a time, Mr. Spock. Sound good.
Captain, I would not advise stepping into that scanner.
No other way around, Spock. Captain Kirk of the USS Enterprise, we have a shuttle ready for your evacuation.
While we appreciate your assistance, our captain and many of our top scientists are trapped in the transporter room on the other side of the station. We cannot simply abandon them.
Any suggestions, Mr. Spock?
If we were able to reach them, Mr. Scott may then be able to obtain a manual lock on our positions.
I'm afraid that may prove impossible. All interior passages are blocked.
Will the suits hold up out there?
With the solar shield failing, direct exposure would mean certain death.
Well, I hate certain death. Spock, let's try to avoid direct exposure.
Captain, I will offer whatever assistance I can over your communicator. But again, I fear that these efforts...
Yeah, we get it. Certain death. Any other words of advice?
Try to live long and prosper.
Should engage mag boots now, sir. The solar collector is failing. We must avoid direct exposure.
That suit is gonna melt off your back. Get into cover, Spock.
Captain, we should stay in cover until it regenerates.
Got it. Wait for it. Go, now!
Exposure our suits can handle. Captain, we should stay in cover until it regenerates.
Whose idea was this anyway?
I believe it was yours, sir.
Right.
Captain, stay in cover. Core. We seek whatever further assistance you can provide.
The only way forward is to shut down the core's rings. To do this, you will need to work together. One of you must scan the control console to stop the ring. This will allow the other person to engage the locking mechanism. Commander, I must warn you, a manual shutdown under these circumstances is highly risky.
Gotcha. You should split up.
I see the locking mechanism, but I will be unable to make an accurate shot until the ring is slowed down.
I've stopped the ring. Spock, shoot the lock.
Captain. We must repeat the maneuver for the remaining rings. Release the mechanism.
One of us has to stop it to expose the brake.
Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism.
Damn, it's moving again!
Is stopped, that brake is exposed.
Another one down. Just one more ring to go. This place is falling apart!
Release the mechanism. We need a way to permanently stop the rings. When the ring is stopped, that brake is exposed.
One of us has to stop it to expose the brake.
When the ring is stopped, that brake is exposed.
Damn, it's moving again!
Perhaps a phaser blast would release the mechanism. Permanently stop the rings. Captain. Now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism.
One of us has to stop it to expose the break.
When the ring is stopped, that break is exposed.
Damn, it's moving again!
Perhaps a phaser blast would release the mechanism. We need a way to permanently stop the rings. Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism.
One of us has to stop it to expose the break.
When the ring is stopped, that break is exposed.
Damn, it's moving again!
Perhaps a phaser blast would release the mechanism. We need a way to permanently stop the rings. Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism.
One of us has to stop it to expose the break.
Exposed.
Damn, it's moving again.
Perhaps a phaser blast would release the mechanism. We need a way to permanently stop the rings. Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism.
One of us has to stop it to expose the break.
When the ring is stopped, that break is exposed.
Damn, it's moving again!
Perhaps a phaser blast would release the mechanism.
Find some cover, that's an order.
We need a way to permanently stop the rings. Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism.
One of us has to stop it to expose the break.
Quick, behind those barriers.
That break is exposed.
Damn, it's moving again!
Perhaps a phaser blast would release the mechanism. We need a way to permanently stop the rings. Now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism. When the ring is stopped, that break is exposed.
Damn, it's moving again!
Perhaps a phaser blast would release the mechanism. We need a way to permanently stop the... Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism.
One of us has to stop it to expose the break.
When the ring is stopped, that break is exposed. Perhaps a phaser blast would release the mechanism. Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism.
One of us has to stop it to expose the break.
I can scan it to stop the rig. Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the locking point. The effect appears temporary. When the rig is stopped, that break is exposed. Success, Captain. We must repeat the maneuver for the remaining rings. We need to split up if this is going to work. A phaser blast would release the mechanism. Another one down. Just one more ring to go. This place is falling apart! I've stopped the ring. Spock, shoot the lock. Moving! Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism. We need a way to permanently stop the rings. When the ring is stopped, that break is exposed.
Outward, let's keep moving.
Quick, find those barriers.
Find that stranded crew.
Great, no cover.
I believe we may be able to open those vents. Perhaps our phasers will work.
Worth a shot.
Shoot the vents to create cover.
Watch out!
upgrades.
Inside.
Captain, life support is now at 4% and failing. Transporter is still unable to obtain a reliable signal.
Let me worry about the transporter. Just get your people ready to beam out. What are you waiting for?
I was speaking to my captain.
It's all right, Commander. Do as he says.
Aye, Captain.
Captain. I don't believe we've met. I'm James Kirk, captain of the USS Enterprise. And you are?
I am in need of assistance, Captain.
T'Mar?
Mr. Spock, it is a relief to see you here.
T'Mar, in what way can we assist you?
Our station has experienced a complete loss of power. Our transporter functions are also unreliable. There does not appear to be a safe way to beam out.
There's always a way. Scotty, think you can get a lock on me?
I'll try, sir. What's going on down there, Captain?
That was a wake-up call, Mr. Scott. I need you to work a little faster.
On it, sir.
We should make our way to the transporter, Captain.
After you. So, how do you two know each other?
We were classmates back on Vulcan.
Just classmates?
I realize this may be difficult for you to understand, Captain, but on Vulcan, relationships between the... Sexes do not automatically imply an intimate past.
Another reason I'm glad I'm not a Vulcan.
We should engage mag boots now, sir. The solar collector is failing. We must avoid direct exposure.
That suit is gonna melt off your back. Get into cover, Spock.
Captain, we should stay in cover until it regenerates.
Got it. Wait for it. Go, now!
Captain, stay in cover. Exposure our suits can handle. Captain, we should stay in cover until it regenerates.
Whose idea was this anyway?
I believe it was yours, sir.
Right. Quick, behind those barriers.
Thank you. We seek whatever further assistance you can provide.
The only way forward is to shut down the core's rings. To do this, you will need to work together. One of you must scan the control console to stop the ring. This will allow the other person to engage the locking mechanism. Commander, I must warn you, a manual shutdown under these circumstances is highly risky.
Gotcha. We should split up.
Ambush!
Their numbers are overwhelming. Surrender may be our only option.
No! Don't give them an inch!
Captain, grenade!
It is your move, Captain.
I'm aware of that, Mr. Spock. Damn it!
Your choice was valid, Captain, but highly predictable.
Predictable? Since when have I ever been predictable?
That is precisely why the move was predictable, Captain.
Captain, we have received an emergency signal from a nearby space station. Please report to the bridge at once.
Shall we finish the game later, or do you concede defeat?
You should know me better than that by now, Spock. I never concede.
Try reversing the phase oscillation?
That's the first thing I tried.
I'm stumped.
What's going on down there?
The radiation from those binary stars is making communications difficult, but the station appears to be in some sort of distress.
Check off readings.
They're operating on emergency power and are struggling to maintain altitude.
Cause?
Unknown, sir.
Captain, they have issued a request for immediate evacuation.
Then let's help them out. Mr. Scott, prepare transporters.
I wouldn't recommend it, sir. Those stars are giving off too much interference. Unless we achieve manual lock, we might fry those little guys.
Then we'll get them out the old-fashioned way. Prepare my shuttle and meet me in the bay.
Aye, aye, sir.
Captain, in spite of your seemingly endless desire to stretch your legs, I must remind you that you are still a Starfleet captain. This is clearly a job that Mr. Scott and a few ensigns could handle.
But then I'd miss all the fun.
Sir, the more prudent choice would be to stay on the Enterprise and wait for a response to our hails.
Oh, you're right.
Lieutenant Uhura, any response to our hails?
None, sir.
No, looks like I'm going.
Lieutenant?
You'll be careful, won't you?
Caution is in my nature, Niora.
I know.
Captain, I must insist.
You insist? You know what, Mr. Spock? A change of scenery might do you some good.
Captain?
You come with me.
Your shuttle's ready, Captain. But do you think it's wise to go yourself? I'm sure me and some recruits could handle this.
Don't worry, Scotty. We'll be fine.
Always makes me nervous when he says that.
Spock, get suited up.
Enterprise shuttle, confirming approach at 5x6. Maintain minimal safe distance.
Affirmative, Enterprise. I'm picking up high levels of radiation from two binary stars.
A normal space station would have been fried by those two stars by now. What the hell are they doing out there?
Captain, the station appears to be outfitted with solar collectors, but they are unlike any I have ever encountered.
Mr. Sulu, do you have any clue what an experimental power station would be doing out here in the middle of nowhere?
Negative, Captain. Whatever they're doing, Starfleet doesn't have any record of it. Preparing for final approach.
Keep the engine running, Mr. Sulu. I don't think we plan on staying on that thing for too long.
Aye, Captain.
Officer, where is the captain of this station?
This way. You must hurry.
Damn it!
Is this the fun you were afraid you were going to miss, Captain?
Right. We need to get everyone out of here right away.
Captain, we must find an alternate route.
Very perceptive, Mr. Spock.
Captain, we're picking up some strange readings. There appears to be some sort of anomaly.
We kind of have our hands full. Anything we need to worry about right now?
The readings are off the charts, sir, but I don't think so.
Just keep an eye on it, Mr. Chekhov.
Aye, aye, sir.
Combined efforts might open the door.
He's stuck in there. Let's get him out of there.
I believe the door can be hacked from this side.
Please, you must be quick!
In your debt.
Formalities are unnecessary. Please proceed to the shuttle bay for immediate evacuation. Captain. I must mention that many of these crew members appear to be Vulcan.
Your point.
With fewer than 10,000 Vulcans remaining, I question the logic of placing them on any type of experimental power station.
I question putting anybody on this thing, Mr. Spock, Vulcan or not.
Agreed, sir. Are most assuredly connected.
One catastrophe at a time, Mr. Spock.
Thank you.
doesn't sound good.
Captain, I would not advise stepping into that scanner.
No other way around, Spock.
Captain Kirk of the USS Enterprise, we have a shuttle ready for your evacuation.
While we appreciate your assistance, our captain and many of our top scientists are trapped in the transporter room on the other side of the station. We cannot simply abandon them.
Any suggestions, Mr. Spock?
If we were able to reach them, Mr. Scott may then be able to obtain a manual lock on our positions.
I'm afraid that may prove impossible. All interior passages are blocked.
Will the suits hold up out there?
With the solar shield failing, direct exposure would mean certain death.
Well, I hate certain death. Spock, let's try to avoid direct exposure.
Captain, I will offer whatever assistance I can over your communicator. But again, I fear that these efforts...
Yeah, we get it. Certain death. Any other words of advice?
Try to live long and prosper.
Interesting result.
Should engage mag boots now, sir. The solar collector is failing. We must avoid direct exposure.
That suit is gonna melt off your back. Get into cover, Spock.
Captain, we should stay in cover until it regenerates.
Got it. Wait for it. Go, now! Those barriers.
cover. It's getting hot out here. I am uncertain how much more exposure our suits can handle. Get into cover. Whose idea was this anyway? I believe it was yours, sir. Right. Find some cover. That's an order. Seek whatever further assistance you can provide.
The only way forward is to shut down the core's rings. To do this, you will need to work together. One of you must scan the control console to stop the ring. This will allow the other person to engage the locking mechanism. Commander, I must warn you, a manual shutdown under these circumstances is highly risky.
Gotcha. We should split up. I have located the control console. I believe I can scan it to stop the ring. Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the locking. Success, Captain. We must repeat the maneuver for the remaining rings.
We need to split up if this is going to work.
That brake is exposed.
Another one down. Just one more ring to go. This place is falling apart! I've stopped the ring. Spock, shoot the lock. Moving again.
Captain, we should stay in cover until it regenerates. Perhaps a phaser blast would release the mechanism. We need a way to permanently stop the ring. Captain, now would be a good time to shoot the locking mechanism.
That worked. Let's keep moving.
Take cover.
Through the core, let's find that stranded crew. Great, no
cover. I believe we may be able to open those vents. Perhaps our phasers will work. Worth a shot. Sir, we can shoot the vents to create cover. Oh, watch out! Successful. Success, Captain. Captain, we should stay in cover until it regenerates. Wait. This one is still alive.
Quick, let's get him inside.
Captain, life support is now at 4% and failing. Transporter is still unable to obtain a reliable signal.
Let me worry about the transporter. Just get your people ready to beam out. What are you waiting for?
I was speaking to my captain.
It's all right, Commander. Do as he says.
Aye, Captain.
Captain. I don't believe we've met. I'm James Kirk, Captain of the USS Enterprise. And you are?
I am in need of assistance, Captain.
T'Mar?
Mr. Spock, it is a relief to see you here.
T'Mar, in what way can we assist you?
Our station has experienced a complete loss of power. Our transporter functions are also unreliable. There does not appear to be a safe way to beam out.
There's always a way. Scotty, think you can get a lock on me?
I'll try, sir.
wake-up call, Mr. Scott. I need you to work a little faster.
On it, sir!
We should make our way to the transporter, Captain.
After you. So, how do you two know each other?
We were classmates back on Vulcan.
Just classmates?
I realize this may be difficult for you to understand, Captain, but on Vulcan, relationships between the sexes do not automatically imply... an intimate past.
Another reason I'm glad I'm not a Vulcan.
I've got manual lock, Captain. Ready and waiting for transport.
See? There's always a way. After you, Captain.
I will not leave this vessel until my crew is safely out of danger. As a captain yourself, I'm sure you would do the same.
I like this one.
There are a few that you do not like, Captain. Prepare to energize.
Thank you.
Back to the shuttle. Run! Keep moving!
I do not think this station is salvageable, Captain.
Oh, you think so?
There is no time to stop.
No time to watch the sunset. Run!
Are you all right, Captain?
I'm definitely better now, thanks.
Captain, we have a problem.
Another one?
What is it, Mr. Chekov?
I think you need to see for yourself.
Tomorrow, a simple solar flare should not have caused the loss of power to your station. Do you know the origin of your vessel's malfunction?
It did not malfunction.
Didn't appear that way to us.
That station was used to harness the energy from the binary stars. However, all of the station's primary controls were operated from a base located on a nearby planet.
What planet?
We are calling it New Vulcan.
So it is true.
Thank you. Spock, as you know, after the destruction of Vulcan, we have been searching for a suitable planet to rebuild our race. New Vulcan seemed perfect. However, a project of this magnitude would have taken generations to complete. In order to speed up this process, we created a device called the Helios Machine.
Your station was to harness the energy from the binary stars to power the Helios Machine located on New Vulcan.
Precisely. 2 days ago, and for some unknown reason, the power to our station was shut off. Without power, our station could not withstand the gravitational pull of the stars.
What moron would shut down the machine if they knew this would happen?
That moron would be Serac.
Never heard of him.
Serac is Tamar's father, and a great mentor to myself and the Vulcan people.
Sorry?
Why would Serac shut down power to your station? He must have been aware that doing so would be catastrophic for you and your crew.
Unfortunately, the Helios machine may have caused an anomaly.
An anomaly? This just keeps getting better. We need to get to the bridge. Chekov, tell me something.
It is highly unusual, sir, but I believe it's some kind of rip in the actual fabric of space.
Like a wormhole?
Something like that, sir. It appears to be a shortcut through space.
Where does it lead?
There is no way to know for sure, Commander.
I believe that rip is the reason my father ordered the Helios machine to be shut down.
Then we need to talk to him right away. Lieutenant Uhura, hail New Vulcan.
Aye, Captain.
It is no use, Captain. We lost communication with them when the Helios machine was shut down.
Captain, scans indicate the rip is contracting. At the current rate, it will be gone in approximately 12 hours.
Good. The fewer anomalies we have to deal with, the better.
Captain, no response to our hails.
Mr. Sulu, bring us in range of New Vulcan. We're going down there.
I may have to cancel our dinner plans.
So, this Tamar, is she a friend of yours?
We went to school together on Vulcan. As a child, many of my peers resented my human side. Tamar did not.
I see. So, were you and Tamar?
I can assure you that our relationship was strictly platonic.
I didn't mean...
No offense taken. I would be more than willing to discuss my past with you any other time. I must request permission to join you, Captain.
Spock, are you sure that's within protocol? I mean, maybe we should just send Scotty and some recruits.
Captain, I hope the importance of New Vulcan is not lost on you. Our people cannot afford another tragedy. This planet is the best hope for our race to prosper.
Noted. Then you should also note that having a Vulcan as a member of your away team would be essential to the success of this mission.
And I am the only one on this ship that has ever been on the surface of New Vulcan or has experience with the Helios machine.
All right. Great. Now there's two of you guys driving me nuts.
Transport ready, Captain.
My phaser, Mr. Scott?
I've put some wee modifications on it, just like you asked. I've been working on some other options, too. I've got phase cannons, photon disruptors, and wait till I show you these plasma rifles. Still working out a few things.
My phaser will do, Mr. Scott.
I guess you don't want to hear about the stasis grenades, then. Nasty little buggers. But if you want your phaser, here's your phaser.
Energize. Any further out and I'd be back in Iowa, Mr. Scott.
Sorry, sir. Too much interference. I had to drop you outside.
Kind of quiet around here. Is that normal tomorrow?
Negative, Captain. for some reason, the highest security protocols have been enabled on this door.
Can we hack it?
Possibly, but you will have to work together to beat the encryption.
This is a more complex security protocol, but together we may be able to defeat it. Captain, the system seemed to have been purposely shut down.
I can provide assistance.
Tamar, can you operate all the systems from here?
Yes, I helped build and design. Captain, if you are implying that I should stay behind...
Tamar, we may need your technical assistance should things get...
Unfriendly?
Unpredictable.
But my father...
When we find him, you'll be the first to know.
I will remain in constant contact.
Thank you.
Captain, shall we proceed?
After you.
I believe we have a problem.
Really? But you can't make that jump.
It is highly doubtful that either of us can cross unharmed. They are dead, Captain.
Anything?
Readings are inconclusive.
Very comforting.
Guy wasn't right in the head.
I am relieved we were able to spare that individual's life.
Me too. Let's keep it that way. Stun only from this point out.
I think he's been poisoned.
Scans show numerous toxins in the adrenal gland. And bloodstream. Disturbed individual.
We gotta take him out, but remember, stun only.
I would not have it any other way.
Is someone there?
This door is locked tight. We need a code.
A mind meld may be our only chance to find out what has happened.
Are you sure you want to touch that guy?
A mind meld is our only option.
Anything?
I have never encountered this before. His mind has been corrupted. Also, I now know the code to that door.
Enterprise, we have injured. Prepare to transport.
Aye, sir. Everything all right?
Yeah, just some Vulcan problems.
So, the usual.
Several Vulcans behind this door, but their readings are erratic.
May I suggest setting our phasers to stun? After all, they are Vulcans.
My body must be a cure.
Let's find this Serac guy and get the hell out of here.
Yeah.
Officer.
Quickly, come in.
Most curious. Fascinating. Osaventsu.
Spock.
Sirach, I am relieved to see you unharmed. This is my commanding officer, Captain Kirk. Captain, this is Sirach.
Pleasure.
And Timar?
I am here, Father.
Timar, I am pleased to hear your voice.
Now what the hell is going on down there?
We have been attacked. Creatures of an unknown origin. They emerged from the rip not long after it appeared.
What creatures?
We have only been able to decipher that they call themselves the Gorn. Spock. We cannot allow the power of the Helios machine to fall into their hands. It would be catastrophic.
How would they be after the machine?
They could use it to create rips anywhere in the universe. They would be able to attack without warning.
Where's the machine now?
Further underground, in the colony's deepest labs. I have secured all entries into the lab to prevent the device from falling into hostile hands. Timar, are you able to provide additional assistance?
I can open the fire door that leads further into the labs. After that point, I will no longer be able to assist them.
Your guidance is all we ask.
Then I advise caution. There are likely to be more infected Vulcans up ahead.
Got it.